Hello friends, today's topic is Fresnel's half period zones. In the last video, we talked about Fresnel's assumptions. First, Fresnel's assumption was that a wavefront is considered to be divided into large number of small zones called as Fresnel's zones. Now we'll explore the properties and constructions of these zones. These zones are imaginary lines drawn on the wavefront. So in Fresnel's class, we have two kinds of wavefronts. Either spherical or cylindrical. Here in the upper part we have a point source which is giving out a spherical wavefront, and the lower one is a cylindrical wavefront. In order to construct imaginary wavefront, first we need to decide what will be our observation point. So for that we will draw a screen and let us call it XY. Here screen is indicating only observation point and is totally optional. We can always take a point directly in space. First step in construction of zones would be to join the source to the point of observation. Then the point at which we want to create zones. In order to construct zones, we will here draw concentric circles centered at C. We can only see its half part as other is on the other side of the sphere. Keep in mind that these zones are imaginary lines which we have drawn and don't exist in reality. Now, similar to spherical wavefront, we also have cylindrical wavefront in Fresnel's class. So, what could be the shape of wavefront in this case? You guess the shape of wavefront by the time I will number these Fresnel's zones. So, first one is 1, 2nd, 3rd and 4th. These are circular wavefronts. So the same thing you are looking at the bottom of the sphere also. So I have 2, 3 and 4. Now can you guess what will happen in cylindrical? Let us apply same procedure that we did for spherical and draw the end of the wavefront. And the line joining the center of the source to the observation point. Here we won't get circles, rather we will get strip kind of zones. Difference between these two zones is that when we have circular zones, area of each zone is same, and that does not happen in strip kind of zones. But most of the time we come across circular zones only. If we want to number these zones, 1, 2, 3, I cannot see the other side 1, 2, 3, but rather that will be on the back side of the wavefront. For simplicity of calculation, we always assume that source is at infinite distance and we are only assuming a very small section of the wavefront in order to draw the zones, because of which zones lose their curvature and can considered to be flat in nature. To recap, with point source at a very large distance, nature of zones would be concentric circles, and if we have a line source which is source of a cylindrical wavefront at very large distance, zones associated would be kind of rectangular strips. Now let us discuss in detail about properties of these circular zones. This rectangle is a big wavefront on which these are the circular zones which are drawn, and we have a observation point at a distance P. And the distance from the center of the zone to point P is B. Now let us join the onset of second zone to the observation point P. Now obviously this distance would be greater as compared to the original distance B. According to Fresnel's zone, this distance from second zone to the point P is given by B plus lambda by 2. Similarly, let us join rest of the zone to the observation point P. So in this picture, we can see three zones, first at the center, second and third. Now, as the difference between first and second zone is lambda by 2, similarly, third distance would be B plus 2 times lambda by 2, and that of the third zone would be B plus 3 lambda by 2. So, you can see that each zone is shifted by half wavelength. That is the reason these are called as half period zones. We can draw n number of such kind of concentric circles, which we are calling Fresnel's zones. So if I have nth zone, then the distance of that nth zone from point of observation P would be b plus n times lambda by 2 and are called as half period zones. Now with the help of geometry, let us calculate radius of these zones. So we have R1, R2, R3 radius of these zones and O is the center. So in the triangle OAP, P being point of observation, by applying Pythagoras theorem, we can say B plus lambda by 2 whole square equals B square plus R1 square. In this triangle, OA is R1, radius of this zone. So R1 square can be given by this expression where B square and minus B square will cancel out. So R1 can be given as R1 square equals B lambda. Here we will neglect lambda square by 4 as lambda is wavelength of light which is in few hundreds of nanometer, whereas B is a physical distance of that zone from the observation point which will be in some centimeters, let's say. Lambda square by 4 term is very big as compared to B lambda. So let us neglect it and we get R1 square equals B lambda, which gives radius of first zone as root of B lambda. Similarly, we will have R2 from triangle OBP as root of 2B lambda and R3 as root of 3B lambda. Thus, we can generalize it as radius of nth zone would be Rn equals root of NB lambda. In this way, we can calculate radius of various zones. Let us go next to area of zones. In order to calculate area of zones, we have to calculate area of each circle. So, as I have numbered here zones 1, 2 and 3, let us first calculate area of first zone. Area of circle is given by pi into radius square. And radius is already known to us as root of NB lambda. So area of first zone A1 would be pi R1 square. Let us indicate R1 radius of first zone, R2 radius of second zone in the diagram. From this general formula, we have N as 1. So R1 is root of B lambda. From there, we will get A1 as pi into B lambda. Similarly, now let's look at area of second zone. But area of second zone is bit different. Area of second zone is indicated by this shaded portion in the diagram. So in order to calculate area of second zone, we have to calculate area of the circle of radius R2 minus area of circle of radius R1. So let us first calculate them separately. Area of circle R2 would be pi R2 square. We know from the radius equation that for second zone radius would be root of 2b lambda. Hence the area of R2 will become 2 pi b lambda. And similarly, area of R1 as we have already calculated is pi b lambda. Difference of these two will give us area of second zone, which is given by pi b lambda. It is interesting to see that area of first and second zone is same. So, if we keep on calculating areas of various zones, we will find out that area of all the zones are same and is given by pi b lambda. So, in this video, we have looked at nature of half period zones, how to calculate radius of half period zone and its area. So that's it for this video. In the next video, we will talk about Fresnel's explanation of rectilinear propagation of light. Thank you.